can't stress enough how important it is as bass players to be able to identify and know what chords are going on or being played in a song. So we're going to be identifying some of the most common chords, three of the most common chords that you would run into. If you happen to be new here and you're just stumbling across this channel, I'm Derek Bennett from Bass Nation Academy, an online bass education school where you can level up your bass playing to the max. If you're looking to do that, go check it out. Link is going to be in the description. We have live stream classes, personal feedback from me, courses, lessons, all of that good stuff. I'll let you check it out. Link is going to be in the description. Like I said, if you haven't subscribed, go ahead while you're doing that, check that red subscribe button if you haven't already. Let's get on with the lesson. As you guys heard in the beginning, I played three different chords, a major seven chord, a dominant seven chord, and a minor seventh chord. So if you're not familiar with those terms, please familiarize yourself with them. I'm gonna go over them briefly so we can flow through this lesson. So three completely different chords that aren't that much different from each other physically when you look at them on the fretboard, but they all work separately and have a unique function. So the first one, major seven chord. We're just gonna learn how to play them and what the differences are between these three chords. Major seven chord, I'm doing everything in C just so we can have a reference. C, E, B. I'm playing the one, the three, and the seven. I'm omitting the five. Because technically that chord is made up of the one, the three, the five, and the seventh note of the scale. So I'm just playing one, three, seven. This is the way that it will sound, or I prefer playing it on the bass. And it sounds more pleasing than playing it down here or any lower register because it just sounds muddy. So what I really want you guys to focus in on is the difference between each chord and its qualities, especially my beginners. So the first chord, the major seven chord, I have my middle finger, just as a reference, middle finger playing the root note, first finger playing the third, then my third finger playing the seventh. And the scale that you will play over this is an Ionian scale or a regular major scale. There's other scales that you can use over this that have the same properties that you can, you know, get away with, like the Lydian scale. It has a sharp four in it, but you can still play that major seven chord on top of that scale. And that applies for each chord that we're going to talk about. There's several different scales and several different ways that you can use the chord or the scale. All right, so the next one, let's move on. Dominant seven chord. Stay right there in the key of C. So I'm still using that same formation as far as my fingers. My middle finger is playing the root, first finger is playing the third. But now, see the difference between those two, the major chord, major seven chord, and a dominant seven chord. You see what changed there? That one little move makes the difference. So that's the difference between a major seven chord and a dominant seven chord. You're flatting the seventh note and the rest of the notes stay the same. Okay, we got that. And the scale that you want to use over that is mainly, most commonly, the Mixolydian scale. That's the major scale with a flat seven. Now you might have heard in the beginning, I played a little bit different. It may have sounded a little different, but I played one note that was, you know, kind of off from the Mixolydian scale, but it still worked. It's actually the Lydian Mixolydian scale. It's derived from the melodic minor scale source or modes. Okay, so that's the fourth mode of the melodic minor scale. It's only one note different from a Mixolydian scale. So let's say, for instance, Mixolydian scale, Lydian dominant. Only one note changes. So it's a major scale with a sharp four and a flat seven. Okay, I don't want to spend too much time on that, but you guys can see how it still will work because I have the one, I have the three, and I still have the seven. And I'm not technically playing the fourth. I'm not playing that fourth note in the chord, so it still works, okay? So let's move on. Next chord, we have a minor seven chord. Now, let's see the difference between the dominant seven and a minor seven. It's very close, and it moves by half steps, so you have to be very careful about the formation. But once you get the shape down of these chords, you will not forget them. Okay, so difference between a minor seven chord and a dominant seven chord. So here's a dominant seven chord. Now let's play a minor seven chord. So you see what happened right there, right? So my third note, or the third scale degree, moved down a half step. That's the difference between a dominant seven chord and a minor seven chord, okay? And that's most commonly used with a natural minor scale, Aeolian scale, just a regular natural minor, or you can be used with a Dorian scale because it has those properties in it. It has a root note, minor third, minor seventh. You can do natural minor scale, you can do Dorian. Same thing, you can do Phrygian. You can even do Locrian. You can still use that, but it doesn't really go the best with that scale, but it still can be used. So now that you know the differences between those three chords and the properties of each of them, the major seven, the dominant seven, and the minor seven, now that you understand them and can identify them, we can move them around and actually manipulate them to sound a little bit different or just a different placement on the fretboard, because we need to be able to learn how to play them, right? So that's just one way. We can actually move this down, or the easiest way to manipulate these chords and make them sound just a little bit different than, we can take the third of the chord and move it up an octave. Okay, that's the simplest, easiest way. So we're gonna move down here. We're gonna move our C down to the E string on the eighth fret. Then we're gonna move our major seventh, which stays the same. Now our major third, or our third, would be here, but now we're gonna move it up an octave. So that E, we're gonna move up here to the G string. So now we have, sounds really, really nice. You have that low end mixed with the high end with the two upper strings. Sounds really nice. Or, so like I said before, since we know the properties of each chord, we can manipulate them and figure out the dominant seven chord, the minor seven chord, and so on. So we have our major seven here. Remember the difference between a dominant seven chord and a major seven chord, you move that seventh down in half step. So it's the same concept applies, right? And then the difference between a dominant seven chord and a minor seven chord is you move that minor third. You move that third down a half step to make it a minor third. So that's all the chords. And very simple way to manipulate these chords and make them sound just a little bit more embellished. So that's the lesson today, folks. If you have any questions, comments, you guys know what to do. Chat it up in the comment section. I appreciate you guys for hanging out with me every single week, if you happen to be here every single week. But anyway, make sure your notes are coming out clean, clear, and precise. And I'll check you in the next one. Peace.